Today, once again, I'm coming to you from Country Classic Cars here in Staunton, Illinois. And I thought you might like a look at this 1976 Buick Century Wagon. And as you can see, this one's pretty unique for sure, with the piano keys running down the side of the car there. Jordan, not a huge fan of this one. But the only reason I thought this might be interesting, this was actually used in a movie called Behind the Candelabra, which I'm gonna assume is some kind of Liberace story movie that was on HBO. So anyway, I just thought it was kind of funny. I thought I'd give you a look at it. You can see it's got the piano keys going down both sides. I'll tell you what, it's actually a pretty decent car. It's got 32,000 original miles on it. We'll take a little look at it since we're here. There's a shot of it here next to a private jet, looks like. And they have all the information on it here. That's the movie that had Matt Damon and Michael Douglas in it. Anyway, so they have all the information on it. But like I said, it's got power windows, power locks, power seat, and as you can see, it's been really well taken care of over the years. 100 mile per hour speedometer, then you just got a fuel gauge and a multi-gauge there with all your idiot lights and stuff. But of course, air conditioning. I mean, pretty well preserved car, really. I mean, if someone was just looking for a nice station wagon, it is in good condition. Take a look in the back here. I mean, the seats basically look like brand new. And then this one, it actually is a 7-passenger, I guess you'd say, because it's got that rear seat back here that flips up out of the bed floor. Let me see if, I don't know how to open this. There's probably a release on the inside, I assume. Or you have to use the key to open it, I'm really not sure. But you can see it's got flip-out vent windows. I mean, seems like everybody's family had one of these for a lot of years there, like in the 70s and the early 80s. In fact, I actually took my driving test in a big Ford LTD II station wagon. But go ahead and pop open the hood. Yeah, you're way ahead of me.
Touching stuff Matt even touched.
But all original under the hood here. You can see they haven't messed with it at all. Even still has the factory paint on the engine and, you know, valve covers, everything. It is a factory AC car. I mean, it looks completely original except for that master cylinder over there. It looks brand new. Like I said, overall, a nice solid station wagon with 32,000 miles. So, but here we'll look at the specs. Once again, it's a 1976 Buick Century Wagon. And, of course, used in that movie. Cold factory AC, 32,000 miles, 10 grand. But, not too bad, but I just thought it was interesting. Jordan said to skip it, but I thought, yeah, why not? We'll take a look at it.
Sweet thing next.
And then I don't know if I'm really going to do a video on this, but this is a, what is it, 72 Plymouth Fury Sport Wagon, I believe is what they call it.
Comes in salmon and pink.
You can see they got this, it says Honolulu Speed Shop on there. But, you know, it's kind of interesting. It actually has a 400 in it with factory AC and everything. And it's got that Fury front end on it. So, I mean, it's kind of interesting. But I don't think I'll do a full video on it. But I thought I'd just kind of give you guys a quick peek at both of these. But anyway, as always, we appreciate you watching and commenting and everything. And we'll see you later. Bye.